Hey, Sean Jantz here. I'm going to do a quick battle plan for Friday, May 6th, and I'm going to do it on /ES, which is the S&P 500, and /TF, which is the Small Cap 2000. And I'm going to start here with the /ES, and I always start the night on the 4-hour chart, right? I call this the anchor chart. This is going to be the chart that's going to basically control price tomorrow. And then we take all of our bias from the 4-hour chart and we find our entries on the smaller time frames. But before I go into Friday, I want to mention this to everybody. The number one news announcement for traders is the FOMC announcement, which is the Federal Open Market Committee. That's the number one news announcement that everybody has to be aware of. The number two news announcement that everybody, that every single trader, I don't care what you trade, has to be aware of, is the non-farm employment change, which usually releases monthly, and it's usually on the first Friday after the month ends, right? And so this is vital economic data, right? Why traders care. Job creation is an important leading indicator of consumer spending, which accounts for a majority of overall economic activity. And so this number will come out on Eastern time at 8:30. It comes out before the market opens. So I want everybody to be aware of that, that is coming out at 8:30. And basically, the plan could be shot to crap if that comes out and something weird happens, right? And so I want everybody to know at 8:30, there's a huge unknown. Sometimes I've seen non-farm payrolls not do a little. I've seen them do a lot. It just all kind of depends on what the number is, right? And so take that into consideration on everything you do tomorrow. 8:30, you got non-farm payroll. And the thing about the non-farm payroll is sometimes you get traders who, big traders, hedge funds, what have you, they're digesting the news. And then anytime, let's say 10 a.m. Eastern, all of a sudden, boom, they put in a huge position, which smacks you out, right? And so there's gonna be some heightened, there can be some potentially heightened volatility tomorrow. I just want everybody to be aware, right? I'm not trying to scare you. I just want you, just you gotta have market awareness. And so looking at /ES, 4-hour chart, we're literally right there exactly where Wednesday closed. This is exactly where Wednesday's closed, and we're literally at the exact same spot, right? So we're basically right there. I know I drew that pretty bad. We're basically right there at massive decision time for bulls. I mean, this is massive decision time for these bulls. They have to make a decision here, right? And so, in my opinion, tomorrow, all of the money is going to be made if we can get this chart to go higher. There's not going to be a lot to do on this chart if we go lower, as you can see, right? There's not a lot to do, except maybe a breakout play, which I'll talk about. But all of our plots are up going higher. So the only way for me to make a lot of money tomorrow is if this chart makes a bull run, right? And so let's write down middle blue Keltner. It's going to be 51 to 53. And if the bulls really get after it, you got the 63 to 65, right? And so looking at that 4-hour chart, we're at decision time for bulls. We don't have a ton of room left for these bears to keep on going, right? And so now when we move to our plot chart, there's our 5-day high, 293.5, and the bulls have just been coming down, lower high, lower high, lower high, and then here we are hitting a new, that's basically a new monthly low, right? I mean, these bears are large and in charge. But here's, yes, that did make a new 5-day low bubble, okay? But it's just barely. I mean, we're basically right there, like I just drew. We're right there at decision time. It's even where price currently is, right? And so let's quickly talk about if this price goes lower. So the first thing that you're going to want to look for is, obviously, here's our line in the sand. Our line in the sand is basically going to be the 40 through 38. And so if we go lower, I do have question marks for you if we go lower. I can't tell you precisely what's going to happen if we break through. Again, most people are going to be looking for potential breakout trades. And so what I mean by that is you break out, hold pullback, and then you're looking for spread trades, right? Enter, and then take your profits on that minus 0.5. That's basically that's basically all you got, right? I mean, all of a sudden, if something crazy happens with non-farm employment, which, by the way, I think has a huge potential for non-farm employment to be pretty nutso tomorrow. I think it has huge potential. If not this month, then next month for sure. Or the next coming months, I think employment numbers are going to get pretty bad, in my opinion. I think they're going to be really bad. But this sucker, you don't know how far this thing can go. Look at all of our charts, 4 hour, blah, blah, blah. We have no clue how far this chart can go. So basically what I'm telling you, if we go lower tomorrow beyond the 40, question marks. Basically what I'm saying is I'm putting question marks there because I got nothing for you. Do what you want to do. I mean, I don't know. Of course, you want to be looking for, you can be looking for buys, you can be looking, I don't know, you can be looking for whatever you want to look for, okay? I got nothing for you. But what I just mentioned is all of the money is going to be going higher. So the first trade going higher, and it actually already happened, is sell value very low. Let me show you that. Asia session already got that sell trigger. See that? So there's our sell value very low trade. And it's already kind of happened. So, of course, I missed that. I didn't trade that. But you can potentially be looking for that trade again. Let me make sure that shows up there. So there's the sell value very low right there, right? And so basically, if we go higher, we can be looking for that trade again. Now, quickly, if you do take this trade again, it's got to be quick. Why does it have to be quick? Because the 4 hour chart's coming. Like, you can't be selling dailies right here. That's insane. If you're seeing a trigger right there, just like you saw this trigger right there, it's got to be like a 15, 20, 30 minute trade to take your profits, right? And so, just quick, that's our first stop going higher. Now, here's where all the money's going to be made, in my opinion, tomorrow. We need to get through Thursday's POC is what we need to do. We needed to get through it, right? Because you can kind of see that resistance a little bit right there. We got to get through Thursday's POC. We then got to hold pullback. And if we can get this chart to hold pullback, these are spread opportunities. We got targets to the upside, and then our final target is going to be the POCs. We got two POCs right there. And value area high. And plus 0.5 deviation is right there. And the number I wrote down on the middle blue 4 hour Keltner, I wrote down 51 through 53, which is going to put us basically here through here. And so you also got middle blue Keltner. Basically, middle blue Keltner is right there. So get through, hold pullback, spread, take profits. You got take profit on Friday's POC, get through, hold pullback. You got your final take profit. Let me draw this prettier. Get through, hold pullback. Take profit, get through, hold pullback. Final take profit is anywhere right around there. And you go ahead and complete that 80% rule trade to the upside, right? So price comes outside of value, which it has. And if it gets back inside, let me draw this for you. If it gets back inside and holds pullback, 80% chance we're running up there to value very high, which there's a lot of stuff telling us that this is where the bulls want to go tomorrow. Plus 0.5, Wednesday's POC, Monday's POC, middle blue Keltner. So what I'm saying is all of our money's going to be made if we can get a bull run. But again, it's Friday, non-farm payroll. These suckers could ruin us, right? Bears could just disaster us, and then we're going to be screwed trying to figure out what the heck to do, right? Now, of course, we can be looking for sell triggers there, of course, right? I mean, that's going to be a very, very potential, really, really good sell triggers right there at sell value very high. Basically, that can be like probably like a 30-minute candle sell trigger is what you're going to be wanting to look for right there, right? And so, and you try and enter... on the 1 minute lower high right there. But the number I wrote down, if this 4 hour chart gets after it, the number I wrote down to the upside, which is the resistance 4 hour Keltner, 65 to 63. Guess what? Guess what that is? Plus one and Tuesday's POC. So what I mean by that, you get through plus 0.5, hold pullback, and you can probably just likely continue running that sucker up. But here's the catch. If you've got an 80% rule to the upside and you took your profits here, Why are you still trading on a Friday? Call it a day. You probably made $30, $40, $100, $300, $500, $1,000, depending on how many contracts. Why are you still trading? Call it a day. And I'll likely call it a day. If I can get my 80% rule here, I'm going to likely call it a day. So lots of stuff to do tomorrow if we go higher. Not a lot of stuff if we go lower. I don't got much for you. You just got to be careful. But I'll still be in the room. I'll still be in the trade chat or the chat room so that I can help you. Now we move over to TF chart. Basically, the concept is the exact same, so I don't want to spend a lot of time on this. I like keeping these around 10 minutes. I've been going longer lately because I get passionate about this, and I want to explain it as good as I can. But basically, it's the same thing, right? I mean, we're right there at decision time. And middle blue Keltner, 14 through 16. And if the bulls really get after it, 23 to 25. Now we take this information, right? We don't have a lot of stuff going lower. But we take this information, the going higher, okay, on the 4-hour chart. And as we speak, literally as I speak, we're hitting monthly lows as I speak, right? And so basically, you got to be extremely careful on this chart going lower. Anything going lower, you got to be careful. I don't have nothing for you down here. You can look for buy trades, you can look for sell trades, you can look for it all down here. You just got to be careful. It's got to look gorgeous, okay? Here's the trade, right? Potential sell triggers at settlement and value area low, just like ES. And the number I wrote down, middle blue Keltner, I wrote down 14 through 16, which is basically going to put us on that plus 0.5. So obviously, if we get through and hold pullback on settlement, 80% rule to the upside. Friday's POC, Thursday's POC, value area high. There's a really, really good chance that this, if the bulls want to do some damage, we got a potential for an 80% rule to the upside on this chart as well. And then if you get an 80% rule to the upside, more than likely call it a day. But I guess you can look for triggers at VA high. But here's the catch on this value area high. You're so close to the plus 0.5 that this might not hold. You're so close to the plus 0.5 that I'll likely want to maybe keep going. But if you're in a spread, please take your profits on these two POCs. Don't even think about holding for plus 0.5. But it's Friday. It's payrolls. Don't do anything stupid. Get money, make money, take profit. Likely shut your charts down. Okay. So comment if you have any questions for me. And make sure you're recording everything you do. And here's the Gene tool. Make sure to take pictures of all of your trades. Go right there and hit capture image. Say, hey, Sean, I entered right here for an 80% rule. This is where I entered, blah, blah, blah. Post it. But even better, make sure you're recording yourself. And comment if you have any questions.